The movie starts with a woman named Stephanie Smothers, who is a mommy video blogger, featuring crafts and recipes for parents. In her new video blog, she tells her viewers that her best friend Emily Nelson has been missing for 5 days, and Stephanie is helping the police to track her down. Stephanie then narrates how she and Emily met each other for the first time in a flashback, from 1 week before Emily's disappearance. We are shown that Stephanie visits her son Miles in school on International Cuisine Day, where she meets Emily, who turns out to be the mother of Miles' schoolmate Nikki. They become good friends, and Stephanie visits her beautiful house, where she comes to know that Emily is a public relations director for a fashion company. Stephanie finds a dirty painting on the wall and learns that it was from a friend of Emily. After that, Emily talks about her relationship and reveals that she is frustrated by the lack of the success of her husband Sean Townsend, who is an English professor. Stephanie compliments her ring and learns that it was gifted by Sean's mother. Stephanie shares that she is a widowed single mother, and her husband lost his life in a car accident. She also tells Emily that she now lives off her husband's insurance money. Stephanie learns that Sean used to be a writer and realizes that she has studied his book for her research project at the university. While the women chat over martinis, Sean arrives home and Emily greets him. After that, Emily tells Stephanie about her busy routine because of her tough job, which makes Stephanie offer her help with picking up Nikki after school. The next day, Emily calls her and asks her to pick Nikki up from the school. Stephanie takes him along with Miles to the park, where after some time Emily shows up as they watch the kids play. Stephanie takes a photograph of Emily, to which she reacts strictly and asks her to delete it right away. Stephanie becomes embarrassed and apologizes to her for offending her. Later, they arrive home, where Stephanie gives a handmade bracelet to Emily as a gift, and then they sit down to chat over drinks. Emily asks her to make confessions, but then she confesses first and tells that she and her husband got closer to a third person together. When it's Stephanie's turn, she confesses and recalls a memory, revealing that she once got closer to her half-brother Chris. Emily laughs at her and makes fun of her for doing such a thing. In the next scene, Emily as usual asks Stephanie to pick up Nikki, saying that Sean is in London to look after his sick mother who has been hospitalized. Stephanie happily agrees to do the job and takes the kids to her home. In the evening, she realizes that Emily is taking too long to turn up. When Emily doesn't pick up her phone calls, she calls her office after 2 days and learns from her assistant that Emily has left for Miami. She eventually informs Sean about the situation, and he says that he will be returning tomorrow. Next, we see that Sean arrives at Stephanie's home and contacts the police. After that, the police arrive and suspect that the couple might have had a fight, because of which Sean went to London, implying that he has an affair. Stephanie interrupts them and says that she knows the family well and that Sean can never cheat on Emily. While the police interrogate Sean, she learns that Emily doesn't have any family. Later that night, when Stephanie and Sean chat with each other, she tells him about how Emily reacted when she captured her picture a few days ago. Sean says that Emily always does this, and shares that she once deleted his Facebook account when he posted a picture of them. While he wants to leave, Stephanie asks him to stay, saying that he will not find a taxi at that time. The next morning, Stephanie wakes up to the noise of Sean and kids chatting in the kitchen over vegetable smoothies, and later shares the recipe in her video blogger. She also briefs her viewers about Emily's disappearance case and says that Sean is doing his best to find her, with the help of the police. In the next scene, Stephanie shows up at Dennis Nylon's company and asks him about Emily Nylon. After asking his assistant, Kiko tells her that he hasn't been informed of any news that Emily is in Miami. Stephanie suspects that Nylon might be involved, and so she sneaks into Emily's office. She finds a photograph of Emily hidden on her desk and uses it to make missing person flyers. Later, Detective Somerville visits and informs Sean that Emily lied about flying to Miami, as her car has been found at a summer camp in Michigan. Stephanie overhears the conversation between them and updates her viewers in her next video blog. One of the viewers sends her an email telling her that she saw a woman filling up gas in her car in Michigan, and she suspects that she could be Emily. Stephanie shows up at Sean's house and tells him about it. Just then, Sean receives a call from Detective Somerville, who tells him to arrive at a lake in Michigan, where Emily's car has been found. Then the police discover Emily's body in the lake. Stephanie and Sean share their grief, and Nikki becomes aggressive. He accuses Stephanie of eliminating his mother to be with his father. Next, we see that Sean and Stephanie begin their relationship. Later, Detective Somerville visits to talk to Stephanie and reveals that he has investigated that Emily and Sean used to fight a lot. However, she doesn't agree and says that the couple used to be worried about their poor financial situation. Somerville further tells her that Emily had severe liver damage, a large amount of heroin, and that Sean has recently taken a $4 million insurance on Emily. Right after he leaves, Stephanie looks around in Sean's room and finds an insurance file revealing that Sean asked Emily to sign it. She visits Sean at his college and is shocked to find him hugging another woman. In the next scene at the dinner table, Nikki says that Emily visited him in school today. However, Sean doesn't believe him and asks him to avoid lying, thinking that Nikki is suffering from the loss of his mother. When Nikki goes to bed, Stephanie finds the bracelet which she gave to Emily. Stephanie talks to Sean about the bracelet, and he tells her that Emily must have given the bracelet to Nikki before her disappearance, implying that she didn't like such things. She learns that the ring Emily had wasn't gifted by Sean's mother, but she actually stole it from his mother. Sean says that he felt very controlled around Emily, but feels very comfortable with Stephanie, who has made him feel like himself again. She learns that Sean took the insurance on Emily's insistence for the sake of Nikki's future, and Stephanie decides to move in with Sean. She takes out Emily's stuff, but as soon as she returns with her stuff to the dressing room, she is shocked to find that Emily's stuff has been put back in its place. In the next scene, Nikki gives Stephanie an envelope saying that it is from Emily. Stephanie finds it an insulting message about her hidden relationship with her half-brother Chris. She receives a call from Emily and then visits Sean, who says that she is just going through a phase of distress. Later that day, Stephanie recalls that her late husband suspected her infidelity and may have caused the accident intentionally. To finish off Chris, after telling this to Emily, they both get closer to each other. But Stephanie stops as she feels embarrassed as the flashback ends. Stephanie looks at Emily's favorite painting and finds that it had been painted by an artist named Diana Highland. Next, we see that Stephanie meets Diana Highland, who reveals that the painting was actually of her muse Claudia, whom she describes as a pathological liar who disappeared after that. Diana's information leads Stephanie to the summer camp in Michigan, where in a yearbook she finds Emily to be a girl named Hope McLendon, who had an identical twin named Faith McLendon. Stephanie then visits a woman named Margaret, who is the mother of the twins. She reveals that the twins had set fire to their family house at the age of 16, thus finishing off their father. When Stephanie shows her the picture that she found on Emily's desk, Margaret recognizes her as her daughter Faith. She hesitates to talk more about her daughters, as she says that they are evil. Stephanie shows her viewers the childhood picture of Emily, which she found at the summer camp, and says that she went there to recall the memories. Then Emily is shown and it is revealed that she is alive. She watches Stephanie's video blog and gets frustrated at her for going to the summer camp and knowing her truth. In the next scene, Stephanie returns home and starts investigating the matter of insurance money that was taken on Emily. Meanwhile, Emily surprises Sean by reappearing. She reveals to him that she plans to take the insurance money and leave the country. When Sean returns home, he meets the insurance guy, whom Stephanie has called to reveal that Emily has an identical twin. The insurance guy says that they are investigating if it was really Emily who signed up for the insurance money. Later, Stephanie meets Emily at the cemetery, where she reveals everything through a flashback. We are shown that Emily and her sister indeed finished off their abusive father. The girls then decided to part their ways and reunite later, but Faith did not show up as agreed. Meanwhile, Emily built her career and family, but then 14 years later, Faith reappeared, and she is now an alcoholic. She threatens Emily that she will confess their crime to the police unless Emily pays her $1 million. After agreeing to pay her, it is shown that Emily drowns Faith in the lake, but Emily tells Stephanie that Faith committed suicide. She also tells her that it was Sean who planned the insurance scam. Emily and Stephanie are both frustrated at Sean. Emily frames him for abusing her and shocks the public with her reappearance. She reveals to the media that Sean wanted her to stage her own death so that he could get the insurance money. Next, we see that Sean gets released on bail and returns home. Stephanie shows up and stages an argument with Sean in front of Emily in order to make her confess that she finished off her twin sister. Stephanie fakes shooting Sean, but Emily reveals that she predicted their plan, and turned off the microphone that the duo had placed to record everything. She shoots Sean in the shoulder and makes Stephanie helpless. Just then, Stephanie reveals that a hidden camera is live streaming everything on her video blog. Emily attempts to escape but is hit by Stephanie's friend Darren's car. And after that, she gets arrested by the police. It is then narrated that Stephanie's video blog was purchased by publishing giant Condé Nast. And later it turned into a morning show. She is a part-time private detective and is dating somebody too. Sean's second novel was a bestseller. And he is currently the head of the literature department at Berkeley. It is also told that Emily is serving a 20-year sentence for her crimes. In the final scene, Emily is shown winning a basketball game in prison. And it is narrated that she has adjusted quite nicely. And the movie ends here.